Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time, I am Precious. On this channel, I help you understand that family and relationship is a work in progress through my videos. Consider to press the subscribe button if you like my videos and also turn on the notification bell for all my returning subscribers. Thank you so much. As a mom of three kids, people say to me, Precious, you've got three kids. How did you manage to get three kids? How are you doing this thing? And I said to myself, you know what? I think I should make a video on what it's like having three kids. So if you're out there thinking about having more than two, maybe three, maybe you should watch this video and that will be able to help you make an informed decision if you're going to go for more or not. So this is my experience and this is my opinion as a mom of three young children. So before you go for number three, or even maybe number four, there are things that you need to consider. Having kids is not just easy. It's something that you need to plan. I know everyone plans for having kids, even if the baby came by accident, like people call it, which I don't believe. That you always have to plan. As soon as you find out that you're pregnant, planning is a big thing. But if you're having number three, there are things you need to bear in mind. Or if you're thinking of having number three, there are things that you actually need to bear in mind before you go for number three. So I thought, why not? I think I'm in a better position to actually talk about what you need to do or what you need to consider before having number three. So without further ado, I'm going to be listing the things that you need to consider before going for number three. Very, very important from a mom of three kids. Okay? So the first thing that you need to consider is support. Support is a big thing. Like, I live in the UK where I don't have family members around, so everything I do is between I and my husband. We work as a team. It's a teamwork. We're not doing it like separately. Anytime we don't do it as a team, there's always a problem. So we work as a team. So for me to have more kids, or for me to have more, we have to agree, we have to plan, we have to have that support. And one of the things that I've done personally is that every time I've had kids, my parents or someone always come around from my country or from just support generally to come and help me when I'm having kids. I've been so great, lucky that my mom has always come around whenever I'm having kids. So do you have a support system? Not just family, friends. Do you have someone you can speak to? You have someone that you can call when you're feeling very, very low? Honestly, you need support. Number three is not easy. You need support. So before you think about having number three, you need to think about your support system, how you're going to cope. One of the things that happen is that sometimes when you're having kids, everyone plans to have a normal natural delivery, but sometimes things happen. You can have cesarean section, things can happen through the delivery process. You may not be healthy, you may not be strong enough to look after the baby the first few days, bearing in mind that you already have two. Someone needs to look after the two you already have, and someone needs to look after the baby. So that's why you need to think about support. You need someone to be able to help you. Your husband is there, you may also need a lot more support. So support is a big thing that you need to think about if you're having number three, because you need it, honestly. You really, really need support because of the uncertainties that may come or that do come with having babies. So another thing you're going to think about apart from support is space. Yes, at the moment I've got three. Okay, there are some times that when they're jumping, playing in the house is vibrating, the house is shaking, you're like, oh my god. If currently you have two, and when your two are playing, you're like, oh god, I can't hear, oh god, this house is gonna fall. You need space. For you to have number three, you need space. Space is very, very important to enable the children play as well. To enable you have that peace of mind, really, that you're not going to be shouting, you're going to fall, you're going to hurt yourself or something. You need space. So space is something that you need to consider if you're going to go for number three. And you know at the moment that you have two, the space is not big enough. Space is important. Another thing that you also need to consider is your car. You ask how you have five-seater car. Someone sits in front. The three seats at the back. Yes, the three seats at the back. But with car seats, three car seats cannot fit at the back of your car. Yes. Currently, we have a big car. Our car is, if you see it from outside, you think, oh, it's going to comfortably fit 3 car seats, but no, it doesn't. So you may want to think about how you're going to cope. If you have a baby that goes on the car seat, you have 2 other kids that need to go on the car seat, you have to think about your car. How are you going to cope? You're going to go for a bigger car? It's up to you to decide on that. But just bear in mind that it's very, very difficult for you to fit 3 car seats on the back, actually on the back. It's actually difficult to fit 3 car seats, and it's not very advisable to use the car seat in front of the car, especially the baby car seat in front of the car. So that's one thing you want to consider, car seat, if it's going to fit in the car. One of the things people do is that they tend to let their first child get to the point where the child can sit in front with their booster seat. So instead of having the the big car seat for all 3 of them, you wait a little bit longer so that the big one will, the first will actually get to the age where they can use booster, then you cannot use the other car seats behind. So think about car seat if it can fit in your car. Another thing you may want to think about is that the house is going to be noisy. Yes, the house is going to be very, very noisy. If you've watched my video, you would notice that sometimes you hear background noise. My kids are playing, my kids are jumping, shouting, and doing all sorts in the background. That's what you get used to when you have a mom of 3 kids who has a YouTube channel. So your house is going to be a lot more noisy. So think about it now. If you have 2 kids and you're already saying, oh God, I can't hear, just keep your mouth shut, be ready. Number 3 is going to be a lot more noisy. But to be honest, noise is fun, you know, because sometimes especially my youngest, when he's quiet, I know that he's up to something, which we all know moms, isn't it? When that your child is quiet, you either know that they are not feeling fine or they are up to something. So noise is part of them being very healthy, isn't it? So that's one thing you may want to consider. If you can't cope with the noise of 2, you may likely not be able to cope with the noise of 3, because the number 3 is not coming out as a quiet child. If 1 and 2 are very, very noisy, 3 is likely going to be noisy because he or she is only going to copy what he sees. So bear in mind that noise is going to be louder and more in your house. Another thing that you may want to consider is that number 3 is easier. Do you believe that? Number 3 is a lot more easier. So with my 3rd child, he grew faster. He became independent faster. The things that his siblings were not able to do at a certain age, he did it a lot more faster. The reason is because number 3 always copy from their siblings, okay? So the things that they do, they see their siblings do, for example, putting their shoes on, putting their coats on, they learn it very fast and they do it. My youngest actually grew faster, as in became a lot more independent. Honestly, at the age of 2, he didn't want you to touch him. Even now that he's 4, right, he doesn't want you to give him a shower. If you leave him, he's going to shower himself. If you leave him, he's going to rub himself as he moisturizes his body. If you leave him, he's going to do everything by himself. That's because he's seen his siblings doing it. So let me just tell you something. Don't let anyone deceive you. I'm a mom of 3. I'm telling you from experience, although this is my opinion. Don't let anyone tell you that number 3 is hard. Number 3 is going to be very hard. It's a lie. Okay, number 3 is actually a lot more easy. It's easier than number 1 and number 2, because number 3 copies number 2, number 1 and number 2. Number 1 and number 2 looks after number 3 a lot more. So you have that support from your kids. So that's on a positive note. If you're worried that it's going to be more difficult, I'm telling you, as a mom of 3, that number 3, my number 3 was a lot more easier than number 1 and number 2. Another thing that you may want to consider as well is that you may not get as much sleep as you used to. If you're someone that likes to get 8 hours, you may not be able to get 8 hours anymore, because you have to check up on your kids. Personally, this is me as well. Personally, I try to check up on my kids like maybe twice through the night. The reason is because I've had incidents where one of them have been sick, you know, like sleeping and they've vomited from sleep. I've had incidents where I checked on one of them and the temperature was really high, and if I had not gone, God knows. So I always like to check on my kids, which affects my sleep because I'm not a very good sleeper. So if you're someone who loves to sleep through the night, to be fair, there is actually a way around it. You could actually get like a monitor to monitor them through the night. That would help. That's another thing you can do. So it's not actually a very difficult thing. So you can still get your sleep as much as possible. But bear in mind that you may not be able to sleep as much as you used to sleep. And another reason why you may not be able to get as much sleep as you used to is, you know, kids can be really ill sometimes, and most of the time they are ill at night. So who needs to go to A&E? You. Who needs to look after them? You. So that's another reason why you have to consider that sleep. You may not get it as much. Another thing that you may want to consider as well is that traveling is going to be a lot more expensive. Because I remember recently we went on holiday, it was a lot expensive. Because the accommodation, we had to get separate rooms. If you've got two, if you've got one, you can have just one room and you all sleep together. But with three, you need separate rooms. So we had to get a hotel with separate room. We had to, flight was expensive, obviously, five of us now. So traveling or going on vacation is going to be a lot more expensive, but you need to think about it. There are other things you can do. You can book ahead of time. So someone that has three kids, you can't just stand up like you want to go on holiday next month. You have to plan ahead of it for you to be able to meet up. So the difference in terms of going on holiday is just to plan way ahead, honestly, but it's a lot more expensive. That's something you may want to consider when it comes to having number three. Another thing you want to consider is that you're going to compare a lot. Yes, you're going to compare a lot. I know that many people have said to us parents, don't compare, it's not good to compare your kids. But think about it, you have two kids now, and in your head you're already comparing the two of them. So when number three comes, you're going to compare more. That's one thing you need to consider. You are going to compare more because we're just human, you know. You can't change it. You're going to compare more, but though it's not good. But that's one thing you need to bear in mind. Number three, you're going to compare more. Another thing that you need to bear in mind is that you need to accept that you may not be able to cope. Right, things happen. Like when it comes to having children, is one thing that's actually made me to learn to have an open heart. Right, I don't really think it's advisable for you to plan, structure how that child is going to be, how number three is going to be, how you're going to do. It doesn't work sometimes, you know, because getting pregnant, you may have an easy pregnancy. Delivery can just mess you up, right? Delivery things happen. You may have a cesarean section. You may have one difficult delivery where after the baby comes, you may be unwell for some time. So that's why support also comes into play. You need that support system to be able to help you through this difficult time. But the point I'm trying to make is that have it in mind that you may not cope with number three. You may not cope maybe at the beginning. When you have that in mind, the expectation that you have of yourself, the expectation of you have of your child, you will not have it. You will just have an open mind. Okay, if the baby comes, we'll cope, we'll manage. However it comes, we'll cope, we'll manage. So bear in mind that you may not be able to cope at first. As time goes on, you would cope a lot more better. And time makes things easier and smoother. Another thing you also want to consider is that someone that has three kids, people are going to have a lot of opinion about you. Ask me about it. You tell someone, oh, how many kids have you got? I've got one. One. How many kids have you got? I've got two. Two? How many kids have you got? I've got three. You've got three? It's like having three children is a taboo. So you have to know that people are going to have both negative and positive opinion of yourself, of you, for just having three children. For me, I've always said to myself, if I want to have 100, provided I can be pregnant with 100 and give birth to them, it's none of your business. Provided I'm having the 100 that I can look after, it's none of your business. So I have this wall around me that nothing you're going to say is going to affect me. So if you're going to be having number three, bear in mind that people are going to have opinion of you. Sometimes it's going to be negative, sometimes it's going to be positive, but just bear that in mind so that it's not going to affect you. So guys, these are the things that I think you need to consider if you're going to go for number three. These are the things that I personally have experienced and I am still experiencing as someone who's got three kids, right? And who knows, I might even go for number four. So if you want to go for number three, I would advise you to think about it and have an informed, or make an informed decision based on what I've just said and based on other things that you're going to be considering. If you're someone that have more than three kids, or you have three kids and there are other things that you think people need to bear in mind, people need to think about this thing before they go for number three, let us know in the comment section, and even number four as well, let us know in the comment section. But for now, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it and you think it actually beneficial to you, please press the subscribe button and the notification bell. Thank you so much for watching. Be grateful, be positive, and be yourself. See you on my next video.